Guys, you are most welcome again on my channel. And if you really love to read English literature material, you can check out my blog Koji Study. And this is the post there. You can read it if you don't like my voice. Let's talk about Renaissance today. By the way, if you don't know, let's see first some basic facts. Renaissance was a cultural and artistic movement, and Renaissance means revival, birth of classical learning in England. It was between the late 15th century to early 17th century. This is time period. Where is the best birthplace of Renaissance? It started in Italy in the late 14th century. Some important events of the time was with Battle of Bosworth Field. The name of the battle was Battle of Bosworth Field. You can see here, huh? Ended the War of Roses. It inaugurated the Tudor dynasty. But remember, the English Renaissance is different from the Italian Renaissance. Do you know why and how? Because of the dominant part. So what was the dominant part? The another question. Literature and music in English Renaissance and visual arts in Italian Renaissance. Remember this. I know I have misspelled this. But important fact is, in English Renaissance we find literature and music dominant part, and in Italian Renaissance we find visual arts. Now the question is, when it really started and ended? Literary historians say it started in 1520s and continued nearly 1620, from 1520 to 1620. Now it's high time we should talk about a guy named Shakespeare. We all know about Shakespeare, when he was born and when he died. He was chief figure of English Renaissance because he wrote so many plays and sonnets, and he was a humanist. I think it's enough. And Renaissance spread because of one thing more: printing press. It played a great role. Nobody was writing with hands that time. Now they can print. It was the mid of 16th century when this happened. And how can we forget this sweet guy, Edmund Spenser? He came with his Fairy Queen. You can watch this short video for some extra bits of gyan. Okay, I will put here the link later. What else can you keep in mind? Declaration of Independence from the Catholic Church. This also helped, you know, growing of Renaissance. Technological advances and sailing and cartography. Actually, people were sailing here and there, and they were collecting some knowledge. They were bringing lots of knowledge to England, and they were finding some new Americans also. A new world. Okay, Vasco da Gama. Technological advances in sailing and cartography. Here are the people. Because of them, you have great literature to read, to enjoy, and to remember. For especially exams. If you have your exam, you cannot enjoy, but you must remember the things. Christopher Marlowe, Shakespeare, Ben Jonson, Thomas More, Roger Ascham. And you know this Cham. You must remember one fact about this Cham. You must remember. He trained Elizabeth, and she became the product of Renaissance humanism. Humanism was also a peculiar quality of Renaissance. You know who wrote the poem of on Monsieur Departure? Elizabeth. She was a queen, but she wrote a poem there on Monsieur Departure, and she was patron. She loved things like poetry, plays. Some other things happen in this period, like Book of Common Prayer got published 1549. And while reading this topic, keep in mind the time period 1520, 1620. Whenever you are studying a period and in English literature, keep that period. You know, the time period must be very clear in mind. Then we can learn a lot of things. Do you know when we got authorized version of Bible? The next question for you. 1611 is the year, and it is also called King James Version. Let me tell you, all the Tudor monarchs were highly educated. and that's why they became patron. Now let's talk about a little visual arts. They care much, but some artists were imported to create some piece of arts. Actually, in England, as I told you, in English Renaissance, visual arts were not that much important. Only literature and music. But there were some people who got imported to England to create some pictures of like Elizabeth and the Tudor kings. They were Hans Holbein and Lucas Hornbout, and later Nicholas Hilliard and Isaac Oliver produced some fine works. Finally, let me tell you, the name the Renaissance is our invention. It is not by Shakespeare or other. Remember, this title is to the period has been popularized by the historian Jacob Burckhardt. Remember this one, okay? Here is the name you should remember. All right, Jacob Burckhardt was the historian. In 19th century, some historians questioned the fact that why we call this period Renaissance. Okay, and other people say, okay, the answer is rebirth, revival of the knowledge. Then the people, you know, question that there was a guy named Chaucer and he revived lots of things. Why don't you call that period Renaissance? Like, there are some, you know, some guys worked really hard even before. Like Chaucer popularized English as a medium. He translated works by Boccaccio and Petrarch into English. Okay, I don't remember any professor calling this Boccaccio. Okay, I pronounce it Boccaccio and Petrarch into English. Yes, it was Middle English though. And how can we forget William Langland? He wrote Byers, Plowman, okay, Dream Allegory. John Garver, Thomas Malory, Martin the author, he composed, and John Lydgate, Thomas Hockley. Yes, they really deserve the name Renaissance, and so some scholars find the period questionable. But that's not a cup of tea. Let them discuss the matter. Okay, they are historian, that is their part, how to, you know, find the things to discuss. But we should remember the date, time, and the writers, let me tell you. Okay. The time was late 15th to early 17th century, but remember these names because these all did really hard work to make it a great time to remember, not ramble, it's remember again, typing mistake. These are the guys, Francis Bacon, Francis Beaumont, and Thomas Champion, George Chapman. Francis Herbert, Thomas Jacker, John Dunn, John Fletcher, John Ford, Ben Jonson, and Thomas Kidd, Christopher Marlowe, Philip Messenger, Thomas Middleton, Thomas More, Thomas Nash, William Shakespeare, Sidney Spencer, Tyndale, and Voight. And here is a warning. Literary discussion will never stop in this blog, and I'll keep posting. So now share your views in comment box if you liked. You can put thumbs up on video. And here are so many things you can share on WhatsApp, and you use Google Plus and other, and here you will also get, okay, yes, you will get WhatsApp button here while reading this. So please share this to any WhatsApp group or somewhere. It will help me, it will motivate me to create some more content for you. Bye bye, take care, see you tomorrow. No, listen to me again. Let me tell you one more fact, that if you love this blog, you can subscribe, and there are lots of other things you can get. Okay, here is my WhatsApp number. This is not posted yet, that's why it is writing here preview. And you can send me a message on my WhatsApp group for joining my WhatsApp group. Okay. 8057538826, and there I will make you join. I hope you will enjoy there also. And on my this Koji study, you will get 200 plus posts on English literature, my notes, my PDF, and everything, my videos, and other things. If you love listening to videos or watching videos, you can visit my YouTube channels. And if you love reading on blog, you can read here lots of MCQs, lots of other topics. I hope you enjoy it. Bye bye. Take care. See you next video.